Hello everyone, this is Authors of War Gaming. I'm going in on 1-6!
Wednesday!
We are back at again this here Saturday night. Sorry for the delay, like I said before on the shorts, which by the way, if you guys didn't see last week's short for Metal Gear Part 2, that's because for some reason on our YouTube settings, on our channel, it's set to private. So, but I fixed it, so everything is fixed on there, so you'll be able to see all the updates you can. But we apologize for the inconvenience. So just sit back and relax, guys, while I set everything up. Yeah, sorry I didn't come back to you guys on Thursday. I know I said Thursday last week. It's just I had a family emergency, so I couldn't come. So I decided to come here day before Easter. So where we last left off, Jay.
Where?
We just took out Sniper Wolf. Now, we have to go up to the next door.
Where? What door?
That door.
What door?
That door.
That door? What door?
That door.
Oh.
Alright, so Meryl has been injured, been shot by Sniper Wolf when we last left off. Now, we just defeated Sniper Wolf. Now, we're going to get some answers. Hopefully, Jay. Am I right? I never knew how to get those bullets until now. Alright, as you can see from the blood, obviously Sniper Wolf is not here. So she survived.
I thought she died.
No. Look at the drops of blood.
No, she died.
Alright, ready for the door?
Don't move!
Jay, hands up.
Ah!
Our first cutscene. It only took 2 minutes.
Not even.
Toss your weapon over here. Slowly.
I hate this part.
How come?
You'll find out why.
To come back here. Stupid man.
Looks like Sniper Wolf wasn't dead after all.
Didn't you know that 2/3 of the world's greatest assassins are women? Do you want to die now? Or after your female friend? Which will it be?
I'll die after I kill you.
Is that right?
What?
Well, at least you've got spirit. I am
not the smartest thing to say.
And I always kill what
Julie Monroe.
For my special prey.
Yeah, Jay. Special prey.
Ew.
Oh, I've left my mark on you.
Yep.
I won't forget it. Until I kill you, you're all I think about.
Wow, like an obsession. Ow. That's gotta hurt. Jay, is your mic on?
Yeah.
Check this thing if it's on.
It's on.
It is?
Why?
Hold on. I'll check it.
Congratulations.
Say something.
Say something.
Leave it to me. I want no more exorcism. There you go. Now this is probably, we're going to have more dialogue in this, more cutscenes, so. Look, I could see, Jay.
Do you know who I am? I always knew that one day I would meet you. The man who stole what was rightly mine. The man who stole my birthright. Forget it. Your body is strapped down tight.
You don't say.
I'm the man you stole everything good from. And now, after the sacrifice of our brothers, after 30 long years.
That's a long time.
The two of us meet. The brother of light and the brother.
Do you need his DNA too?
Yes. I want a sample while he's still alive. We need it to correct the genome soldier's mutations.
Then we'll be able to cure them?
No. We still have to get our hands on Big Boss's DNA.
Have they given in to our demands yet?
Not yet.
They won't give in.
Not yet.
They're all hypocrites, every one of them.
Is that your opinion as a Kurd?
They always put politics first.
That's right. That's why they tell me about it. Wrestling. About their precious new
what?
Nuclear weapon.
Politics and wrestling.
It looks yep. like our friend is awake.
Or I forgot to put on Boo Ghost.
There definitely is a resemblance, don't you think, little brother? Or should I say, big brother? I'm not sure. Anyway, it doesn't matter. You and I are both the last surviving sons of Big Boss. It's me. Really? Then what? Oof, those idiots! All right, Raven. I'll be right there. They're not responding to our demands. We launched the first one in 10 hours as planned.
Damn Americans.
Looks like you read them wrong.
Something's funny. Normally the Americans are the first ones to the negotiating table. They must think they've got something up their sleeves.
So it's come down to it, has it? We're going to launch that nuke and ride it all the way into history.
I've got to take care of some launch preparations. You're in charge here, Ocelot.
What about you? Want to stay for the show?
I'm not interested. It's time to feed the family.
Yeah, we know what family it is.
So you prefer your wolves to my show, huh?
Ocelot, don't screw up like you did with the chief.
Yes, I know. That was
yeah, that's another thing. What does he mean by the chief?
Like him would be so tough.
I don't know.
His mental defenses were reinforced by hypnotherapy.
Boss, what about that ninja?
He's killed 12 men. Whoever he is, he's some kind of lunatic.
Bastard took my hand.
Yeah, we could see. Had fun, jerk. I hope you, now if you can learn to jerk off with your left.
Find out what killed Baker, an octopus.
Now you're gonna have to learn to jerk off with your left.
So make this little torture show of yours as short as possible.
Torture? This is an interrogation.
As you wish. See you later, brother.
Pixelated boobies.
Woman is still in this world.
Beryl.
Catch you later, handsome.
Once she picks a target, she doesn't think about anything else. Sometimes she even falls in love with them before she kills them.
I bet.
Finally, just the two of us. How are you
just
feeling?
Just the two of us, Chris.
You and I.
Better yours. Too bad I was sleeping alone.
Glad to hear that. This is some bed, all right. I'm about to show you some of its nicer features.
Where are my things?
Oh, don't worry. They're all there. Washington was taking quite a chance sending you here. Someone must have had a lot of faith in your skill, huh, carrier boy?
So, I hate this
Metal
part.
Metal Gear is armed with a new type of nuclear warhead, huh?
Why don't you go ask Campbell for the full story?
Wow, now something's not making any sense.
You got an optical disc from President Baker, didn't you?
What if I did?
Is that the only disc? There's no other data?
What do you mean?
No, I shoved the other one up my ass.
If not, it's fine.
Is Meryl okay?
She's not dead yet. Wolf must have been feeling generous. What if you want her to stay that way? You better start answering my questions right now.
I hate this part.
You were holding one card key. Where are the other two?
Now I'm just let everyone know I'm on normal.
Trick.
That weasel of a president said there's some kind of trick to using the key.
Hell if I know.
I see.
I just hope I don't die soon.
We're going to play a game, Snake. and we'll find out what kind of man you really are. When the pain becomes too great to bear, just give up and your suffering will end. But if you do, the girl's life is mine. Press the circle button repeatedly to regain
strength.
When you've had enough,
this
press
is what...
the select button to submit.
So remember, guys,
when your life
if I can survive
zero,
the torture,
the
Meryl lives.
There
if
are
I
no
give up, Meryl dies.
Don't even think about using auto fire.
I never got that. I guess it means like an automatic
button. I'm
going to
run a high voltage electric current through your body.
Man, they bypassed that.
Just for a short time, it won't kill you.
But I never Meaning auto fiber, a turbo
You're
controller.
A tough guy, Snake. But I've got
Put the mic to your mouth.
Chris, we talked about this bastard.
Okay, yes.
There's no Geneva Convention. No one is coming to save you. Starting to feel a little scared. Good.
Alright, here comes button mashing.
Okay, let's get started.
Alright. I hate this part.
Okay,
remember when we were teens, I would always die at this part? Okay, come on. Ready? There we go! Come on! Good, I'm at full health. Two more
Can
times.
Go again?
Here comes round two. Ready? Come on!
Had enough yet?
No.
We're not finished yet.
Please let this be the last one.
Want me to go on? Can you take one more?
Oh, shit. Come on! I can do it! No! This is gonna be tough. Especially since I put it on normal.
What's normal?
Jay?
Hey, there's no retry?
No! Remember? He said if you die, the game is over.
No!
I have an idea, but this requires your help.
What are you doing?
Screw it. I'll come get it later.
What?
This is why I hate it. I should have just put it on easy. But now I'm paying the price, so I gotta do this.
Don't move!
Come on. Let's go. Ready? There we go. I got a head start. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Good.
How do you like that?
I gotta survive four times in this. I forgot on normal they do it four. Try again. Come on!
Had enough yet?
Had enough yet?
We're not finished yet.
He's gonna try it again. Keep doing it, Jay. Circle. Keep pressing once it goes. One, two, three, go! Come on, Jay. You almost got it. You almost got it. You did it.
You're a strong man. Well, that's enough for now.
I had to use you, Jay, because my hand was giving out.
You're the boss's brother, all right. Your brother, he's an amazing man.
I think we should do it like that.
Oh, you
F-16s with a Hind helicopter. The Les Enfants Terribles project was not a total failure. He is the one man.
So if you do this on the hardest reality difficulty, it's like 10 or something.
Yeah. He does it more. Alright, before we do anything, I'm going to save. So I don't have to do this again. Then I only have one to do it. Now. Look at this. Huh?
Looks like I got a roommate. The DARPA chief?
Yeah.
What a stench.
I gotta save it here.
Snake, are you okay? I feel so scared for you. It must be horrible.
I've been through a lot worse. Believe me.
Wow, you really are a hero. It's a good thing the codec is connected directly to your inner ear. You can contact us anytime. It's always nice to hear that you're all right. Why don't you contact the Colonel? If anyone can think of a way out, it's him. Please, Nick, don't give up.
I'm not.
Normally, when a soldier is taken prisoner, he should only give up the big four. That's name, rank, serial number, and date of birth. But you're not any old soldier, Snake. I don't want you to tell them anything. Fortunately, you're strong enough to resist. In any case, don't you think you should contact Colonel Campbell?
Yeah, that's kind of weird.
Otacon, are you still okay?
Yeah, thanks to the stealth camouflage, that is.
I have a favor to ask. I need your help.
I was wondering when you'd ask. What should I do?
I've been captured. I'm locked up here in this cell.
What cell?
There's a big torture machine nearby.
Okay, I know it. It's close. I'll be there right away.
Thanks.
Just because you are locked up does not mean there is no chance of escape. Keep your eyes and ears open, and when you see a chance, take it. You should call Campbell and wait for his instructions.
Snake, are you okay?
I've been better.
How's Mera?
They've got her.
Damn. Snake, the government has decided not to give in to their demands.
Too little too late for that. Time.
Come on, Colonel. Why don't you stop playing dumb? I'm sorry about Meryl, but I want the lies to end now.
What are you talking about?
Metal Gear was designed to launch a new type of nuclear warhead, wasn't it? You knew it all along, didn't you?
Yep. See?
Why did you try to hide it?
I'm sorry.
Can't tell the grunts, huh? You've changed a lot. Metal Gear? Secret advanced nuclear weapons research? Does the White House know about this? How deep does it go?
As far as I know, as of yesterday, the President had not been briefed about the Rex project.
Need to know basis, is that the idea?
These are sensitive times. Even subcritical nuclear tests are causing quite a stir.
plausible deniability, huh?
Yes.
Yep.
And tomorrow, the president and his Russian counterpart are scheduled to sign the START 3 Accord.
I get it. That's the reason for the deadline.
That's right, Snake.
And guess who's the president in this game?
This terrorist attack go public.
He's in number two, Jay.
START 2 or dealt with the issue of
George Sears, a.k.a. Solidus Snake.
Reputation and America's place as the dominant superpower.
So patriotism is your excuse for circumventing the Constitution?
Please, Snake. Just stop them.
Why should I?
Because you're the only one who can.
In that case, tell me the truth about this new type of nuclear warhead.
I told you before. I don't know the details.
I don't believe you.
Mm-hmm.
If the situation is so serious, why don't you give in to their demands? Let them have Big Boss's remains.
You see?
Or is there some reason that you can't do that? Something you haven't told me about.
Oh, you find out in number four.
The president has been very vocal in his opposition to eugenics experiments. We don't want the existence of the Genome Army to go public.
And that's the only reason? Huh. Hell with you.
I'm sorry.
The corpse of the DARPA chief is lying right here next to me.
Oh, man.
But it's strange. He looks and smells like he's been dead for days.
Well,
his
blood's
been drained out, too.
Drained.
Maybe to slow down decomposition?
I have no idea.
But the chief only died a few hours ago, right?
Right. But he's already started to decompose.
What could it all be about?
Something in his blood that they wanted?
I doubt it. Just the nanomachines in the transmitter.
Did the chief tell them his detonation code?
I'm afraid so. It looks like they've got both codes and are nearly ready to launch.
Damn. Is there any way to prevent it?
It seems that there's some type of emergency override device that can cancel out the detonation code. It's a countermeasure that ArmsTech installed secretly. You have to unlock it with three special card keys.
And where are those keys?
I've got one of them. I don't know where the other two are. Besides, I'm locked up here.
We've got no choice. Forget about the keys. Your top priority now is to destroy Metal Gear itself. Sorry to have to lay it all in your lap, but you're all I've got. Bust out of there, and get to the communications tower. Also...
What?
I know it's asking a lot.
Meryl, right?
Yeah.
I'll save her.
Say you're welcome.
You're welcome.
Damn, I caught a cold. That witch. She took my clothes.
You see this guy again in the fourth one.
What the hell are you doing?
How do you annoy him?
Shut up in there, will ya? 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 Shut up! Shut up! Shut up! Shut up in there, will ya? Shut up!
I'm just gonna keep annoying him.
Shut up!
Otacon.
I'm headed your way now. Can't you just relax?
I am relaxed. I just don't know how to kill time here.
Okay, I'll be there as soon as I can.
That's what you said 10 minutes ago.
I'm headed your way now.
Shut up! Shut up! What the hell are you doing?
I'll just play hide and seek. Do you think he could find me?
No.
Uh-oh.
Hey, it's showtime. Ocelot wants you.
Time for round two. All right, Jay, I'm going to need you for this again.
I'll tell you once more.
Press the circle button.
We don't need to go through that. One, two, go! Here we go! I got a head start. Come on! Come on!
How did you like Good. That?
I always hit it before it starts.
Shall we go again?
How did you like that, Chris?
Not good. Alright, ready? One, two, go!
Well, this is, they say this is the hardest
This
part
is
of the game.
Hardest part. That's why, because my thumb keeps cramping. Alright, I'm going to try one more time, but Jay, you're going to need to do the last one. Yet.
And say congratulations.
Ready? Come on! Got it! Keep going back up!
Is that okay? Want me to go on?
That's all I can give you, Jay, but just hit it. One, two, three. Now! Hit it, Jay, come on! You got it, Jay, you got it! Keep hitting it.
Why?
You're a strong man.
Okay, we're good.
Well, that's enough for now.
How's your hand?
Fine.
Well, yeah, I had to do three.
Imperialism, totalitarianism, perestroika. 20th century Russia has had its share of problems, but at least they had an ideology. Russia today has nothing.
They're struggling between freedom and order. And with that struggle, a new spirit of nationalism has been born.
What happened?
The boss has a close friend high up in the Russian government. He's currently the head of Spetsnaz.
Yeah, and he's going
to
be a number two.
He's agreed to purchase this new nuclear weapons system. The Hind was just a payment.
So you're in this for money?
I don't need money. I want Russia to be reborn. To lead a brave new world order.
Ha! Yeah, right. Wait till number two gets in. We know what he's talking about from number two.
Well, we're not supposed to talk about that yet.
Yeah, I just find it funny he says that, but in number two he does the complete opposite. Which you guys will see when we beat this. After this one. Everything starts coming together. All the pieces go in alignment.
Well, you're not going to like the fifth one.
We'll get that for another time.
You okay, Snake?
Yeah. Nothing new to report.
Snake, is there anything I can do?
Yeah. My arm hurts.
Poor Snake.
And this is what you do. You take your arm.
Your blood.
Okay. But you can leave out the Benzedrine. That stuff makes me too frisky.
I guess you're not feeling too bad after all. Snake, put the controller up against your arm.
Right here.
What?
Don't worry. It'll feel good.
Huh?
Okay, here I go. How does that feel, Snake? A little better?
How did you do that?
I stimulated.
Doesn't really do much, Naomi. Yeah, so you put the controller on your arm like this. You never did that?
Say something to take my mind off the
pain. You didn't do that?
What can I say?
It's like the same thing to almost Psycho Mantis when you move the controller.
I'm not a very good talker.
Please. Tell me about yourself.
Myself.
All right, here's where we learn more about Naomi.
Any family?
That's not a happy topic for me.
I don't have any family. No. Wait. There was a man who said he was my father.
Where is he?
Dead. By my own hand. Big boss.
What?
Big boss? I had no idea.
We knew that.
Yeah, you did. Exactly, and there's why it's gonna come too.
Only Snake and I know the real truth of what happened there.
So, is it true?
Zanzibar.
Was Big Boss really your father?
That's what he said. That's all I know.
And he burned him to death. Am I right?
Knowing that.
Yeah, he burned him to death.
How come?
How?
He was the enemy.
He wanted it. Besides, some people just need killing.
That's petricide.
Yep. That's the trauma that Mantis was talking about. One we share in common.
Is that why you left Foxhound?
Let's just say that I needed to be alone for a while. Alaska was the perfect place.
Snake. I didn't have a real family either. Just a big brother who put me through school. We weren't even blood related, and he was much older than me.
Where is he?
He's dead.
No!
I'm sorry.
Yep.
Snake, is there a woman in your life?
No.
After you've been through as many wars as me, it's hard to trust anyone.
Yeah. Friends? Gustavo died.
Roy Campbell.
Holly just left, never heard from again.
Call me friend.
Is that it?
There was another. Frank Yeager.
What?
Big Boss's most trusted lieutenant. And the only member of Foxhound ever to receive the code name Fox.
Gray Fox.
Gray Fox.
I learned a lot from him.
But didn't you try to kill each other?
Mm-hmm. That's true. We did. In Zanzibar.
In a fist
there
fight.
There was nothing personal. We were just professionals on opposite sides, that's all.
And you still call yourself friends?
Mm-hmm. Hard to believe. War is no reason to end a friendship.
That's insane.
I first met him on the battlefield. He was being held a prisoner of Outer Heaven. But he didn't look like a prisoner to me. He was always so cool and precise. I was still green, and he showed me the ropes.
You knew him well?
No. We never talked about our personal lives. Sort of an unwritten rule. The next time I saw him on the battlefield, we were enemies. We were fighting barehanded in a minefield. I know it sounds strange to most people, but we were just two soldiers doing our jobs. It's like a sport.
Men in their games. You're like wild animals.
You're right. We are animals.
So if you were friends, then how do you explain the ninja's behavior?
I don't know.
It's your genes. They make you predisposed towards violence.
You really like talking about genes, Naomi. Why did you get into genetic research anyway?
I never knew who my parents were, or even what they looked like. I guess I got into genetics because I wanted to figure out why I am the way I am.
So you studied about DNA?
Yeah. I thought if I studied my genetic structure, I'd find out who I really was. I thought that by analyzing a person's genetic information, I could retrieve the blank spots in that person's memory.
Memory is stored in DNA?
We're not sure, but we know that a person's genetic fate is determined just by the sequence of the four bases in their DNA.
So what about my fate? You know my DNA sequence, don't you?
Your fate? I'm sorry, I have no idea.
Of course not. You're a scientist.
She's lying.
Fortune teller.
I'm headed your way now. Can't you just relax?
He's just gonna keep saying that.
Don't say anything to tease or anger the person torturing you. If you make him mad, it'll be that much worse for you. You'll need to save your strength.
He doesn't really say anything.
I know.
Why don't you contact the Colonel? If anyone can think of a...
If you play the other ones, there's this one, two, right?
Yep.
How many discs were there?
For Metal Gear Solid, there was two discs. Oh shit, here he goes! I love this part.
Does he have diarrhea?
Yes! He's gonna shit his pants. He's gonna be like the Hulk, ripping out the back of his pants.
We know who he is, though.
Hold on. Otacon should be coming here soon.
Right, Chris? We know who he is?
Yep. Akiba. Oh, here he is.
Hey, I'm here.
Where?
Right there.
It's me,
Otacon.
Wow, they even capture you.
Hurry, get me out of here.
Let me go, that hurts.
Hurry up.
Is that how you ask a guy a favor?
Yeah.
Let me go. Jeez, it's
It's like an animal's cage. Oh, what a
smell. That's why they call it a cell.
Yeah, it's the DERPA chief.
You don't hurry up and get me out of here. I'll be laying next to him.
Those bastards. This lock won't open with a security card. You need a key like the soldiers carry.
So what are you doing here, then?
I thought you might be hungry. If you need more food, I can bring some more later. Also,
he asked you to get him out.
It'll get you out of that torture room. Here, take this, too.
What's this?
It's a handkerchief. I got it from Sniper Wolf.
Why?
I don't know why, but she's nice to me.
Sounds like Stockholm Syndrome to me.
Whatever that is.
I was taking care of the dogs here. After the terrorists took over, they were planning to shoot all the dogs. But Sniper Wolf stopped them. She even let me feed them when I asked. She likes dogs. She must be a good person. Please don't hurt her.
Wake up, you idiot. She's the one who shot Meryl.
Well, that's all I can do.
You know the old saying, Jay? Love is blind.
And you have to get past the communication.
You know why he says all this stuff?
Why?
He's in love with her.
I know.
That guard's got the key. You'll have to take him out.
Give me a break. I'm no soldier. I can't take anybody out.
You have to.
He just got done taking a massive diarrhea dump. Okay, guys.
Wait.
There's three ways to escape. The ketchup that he gave you, hide under the bed, or you could... actually, there's four. Or you could kick the crap out of Akiba, run out of there, and let him follow you, and he'll run right to the friggin' bathroom. Or let him lock the cage again, and the ninja, a.k.a. Gray Fox, comes out and frees you.
Which one are you gonna do? The ketchup one?
Might as well.
Oh no. You're bleeding. No.
What the hell?
I'm doing it this way. Don't worry, he ain't dead.
Well, if you,
now let's get back in the gear.
Well, if you,
yeah, but if all else fails,
if you kill him, it's a...
what?
If you kill him, it's a time paradox.
Yes. We don't need any of those right now.
You missed.
That was a close one, Snake. Ocelot. You'll pay for that.
Who else? Nope. Just the bathroom.
That was a bad idea.
You don't say.
Good idea. Bad idea.
Using a Stinger missile launcher to shoot enemies. Bad idea. Using a Stinger missile launcher on yourself. And then we go right in! And it goes, I fucked my grandma.
A rat?
Fucked my grandma.
Say it, Chris. A rat?
A rat? Why did you hump Beethoven?
That was a good movie.
Yes.
Underrated, though.
Well, not to by today's standards, yeah. That worked.
It's a good movie. It's just a little bit underrated, though. But yeah, the first three were good.
Then they tried to make straight to DVDs, which bombed badly.
Did you like all three of them?
I liked only two. I didn't see the other one. And also, Danny Masterson is in one of them. The guy who's currently in jail right now from that 70s show.
La la lu.
Grandma, grandma, grandma.
I wanna have sex with grandma.
I had to see that. That's 15 now.
Huh? Huh?
That's 15 times I've died.
Really?
I don't know.
But I know who is the ninja.
What ninja? There is only one ninja in here.
No. You're forgetting about the other one.
That's not till later.
Yeah. I didn't say who, though.
Yep. You didn't say who. And you said, I wanna go home.
I wanna go home.
I wanna hug grandma.
I don't know which is the best one. It's kind of hard.
And then he goes, get off!
It looks like the place is protected by infrared sensors.
Yeah, we know.
I gotta get out of here.
That's not gonna work. Come on.
Snake, are you okay? Snake?
If he's okay, why does he have to do this again and again and again and again? Are you gonna get all the dog tags in the next one?
I'm gonna try to.
I could never got any of the dog tags.
I mean, I could try to. There's so many dog tags to get, but I gotta remember.
I think there was like 120 or something.
Probably on each one.
I don't remember.
I'm putting that one on easy though, because at least when you shoot them with the tranquilizer gun, they go down right away.
Now there's gonna be a weird boss in the next one. Right?
Yes. A very weird boss. A very creepy boss.
What?
And Jared said, "Mom, don't!" I went, "Mom, don't!" From Doug, remember? Okay, we got Chef. Yeah, Omar's online. Disappointing.
He's been playing the games a lot
and he
lately.
Says he's busy.
He doesn't like seem busy to me.
There. He is the least busiest person out there.
He doesn't look like he's busy, though. He's playing a game now.
Busy what? Playing a game? He looks like, in the words of Agon Fieldgrim, he looks like the most least busiest person out there. Oh, guys, I'm happy to report my future wife, Courtney, which I'll be marrying in 35 days, a month from now.
Congratulations.
Yeah, Omar, you should have told me in advance here. Why did you lie? Am I right, Jay?
No, you should be more annoyed at him.
I am. Yes, sir. Hello, Melica Town.
Hello.
Melica Town, don't forget to like and subscribe to this channel.
He wants to be engaged with you.
Oh, sorry, man. I'm taken.
He's just kidding, though.
I know. But don't forget to hit that like and subscribe to that. Like I was saying, my fiance, Courtney, which I'll be marrying in a month. Love you, baby. Bought me a wedding gift. And Melica Town, you're going to be stoked. She's wife of the year for this. A PlayStation 5 Spider-Man 2 bundle.
Play Spider-Man 2.
I'm playing it tonight.
Because it's a great game.
Yeah, my fiance, and thank you so much, baby. Even though I feel guilty, but thank you.
I don't know why you should.
I don't know. I figure I'm the man. I'm supposed to spend all the money.
It's supposed to be equal.
Yes, it's because Court says it's our money. I don't know. I'm just going to go to... Call me old-fashioned.
So? Yeah, so?
But no, thank you so much, baby. That was one of the best things you ever given me. And this shirt you gave for my birthday, the Ultimate Warrior Always Believe. Wednesday apparently is a traitor to wrestling. Why, Jay? Why? It's gotten better. AEW's gotten better. I don't know about WWE, though, because I haven't been watching.
I think because I'm bored of it for some reason.
What, with WWE?
Yeah, I'm just bored for some reason.
I am, too.
I don't know why.
You're putting characters over that shouldn't be, to me, in my knowledge,
I think because it's Roman Reigns that's still the champion.
They're focusing all in on Roman Reigns.
He better not beat the record. That'd be kind of dumb.
If Cody does not win next week, it is official. He made the biggest mistake of his life. Do I believe Cody Rhodes will go back to AEW eventually?
No.
He will eventually. But as for MJF, he's still under contract. He's still with AEW, and people say he's going to debut next week.
He's not going anywhere.
He's not. Tony Khan's going to be an idiot to let his best player go.
Get to the underground base where Metal Gear is. You'll have to climb the communications tower on the north side of the cave.
Alright. We're 50 minutes in, guys, and we're going to the communications tower.
down the underground passageway north of the cave. You're...
No, I didn't want to do that.
There's just so much talking in this, though. Compared with the other two.
I know. There wasn't much on the NES versions.
Well, the first one wasn't...
Oh, yeah. See, the NES, that was the beginning, and they never knew this would be a big phenomenon.
True.
Remember, the Nintendo versions, they were supposed to be short. But the thing is, they caught on, and Hideo Kojima from Konami actually wanted to make one for the PlayStation 1. Originally, Metal Gear Solid was supposed to come out for the N64. Originally.
Yeah, that would be too much for the system.
But the thing is, the N64 couldn't hold what PlayStation 1 could. That was the problem, because Hideo Kojima wanted to put more emphasis into Metal Gear instead of being an RPG text and scroll. Because remember, the reason why it can hold up to Legends of Zelda's Ocarina of Time and Majora's Mask is because, remember, RPGs and cutscenes are a little bit different with the RPG cutscene. Remember, it's not full motion video like you're seeing in a PlayStation 1, am I right, Jay?
Yep.
Yes, I know N64 was capable of a lot, but they lacked value of doing a full motion video.
That guy didn't even notice you.
Oh, that's good. Well, and don't get me wrong, the N64 will always be one of my favorite Nintendo systems. Till this day.
Yeah, and play Eternal Darkness.
Till this day, I still am jealous of Jay for having an N64. The main reason why is because N64 got the better wrestling games. WrestleMania 2000, No Mercy, WCW versus NWO, WCW, NWO Revenge. Mayhem, that was for both consoles.
Wait, did I get rid of some? I don't remember.
The thing I'm trying to say is the PlayStation 1, we had good wrestling games. Warzone, Attitude, SmackDown. But that didn't come till way later. The PlayStation never got a good, really, a good WCW game. We got Mayhem, but that was decent. But then they ported it for all consoles.
It happened.
Backstage Assault was a fucking joke. Well, it was basically an unfinished product.
You know that was going to happen.
And there was supposed to be another game for the N64 called WCW Big Bang. But it was scrapped because WCW went out of business.
We know.
And then there was a mod now for a wrestling game. It's called Legends of Wrestling, where you're every single legendary color, including my favorite, Ultimate Warrior.
And Andre the Giant.
And Brutus the Barber Beefcake, a.k.a. Disciple, Booty Man, Zodiac, the Man with No Name. Yeah.
You had a tough life.
Well, he got his face busted open. He almost died.
Hey, Hulk Hogan, be friends with him again.
Yes, please. Stop holding whatever grudge you have over him.
Or your real name is Terry.
Yeah, Terry, and his name is Leslie.
See, a lot of people think that that's their real name. No.
No. Diamond Dallas Page isn't his real name. It's Page something.
You know, he wanted to do yoga. And he hated it at first.
He did hate yoga.
Yeah, but not now he's helping all these people.
He helped Buff Bagwell out.
His former wife.
Oh, Kimberly?
Yeah, said like,
they broke off on good terms.
Yeah.
They
and they're still our friends.
Yeah, they're still friends. They divorced on good terms.
See, that's okay if you know.
Yeah.
You know,
Not many people can do that.
No. That's like a rare thing now.
It is.
You know, you can still be best friends with your ex.
I dated someone who was a close friend of mine, and we broke up on good terms, and we're still friends to this day. That's how I want things to be, but sometimes some things are not meant to be that way, and you just have to accept
that. Like,
you
know, if you, you start as friends, and if you want more, then you become boyfriend and girlfriend.
Exactly. And sometimes you're just better off remaining friends as well.
Or just, you know, start from, you know, acquaintances, and then...
Yes. Be like, what's it called? Brutus Beefcake with his wife. I love you, and he's like, okay, I'll be right there. That was the most hilarious thing ever.
So at least some of the dark sides are okay. Like, they're not that bad.
Oh, yeah.
His isn't...
Terry Gordy, though, my God. That was sad.
Yeah.
Well, you could tell when he came out after he had that overdose, he was done. He was like a deer on headlights. And the fact that Undertaker said it wasn't going to work, that was the end of his career as the Executioner. I'm just surprised you never knew about it. I knew the whole time because my dad would tell me it's Bam Bam Bigelow.
Well,
the Freebirds.
I don't know most of them back then.
I know, my dad knew. That's why when we looked at Doc Hendricks, he's like, Michael Hayes, the Freebird!
And they didn't have that Wikipedia thing yet.
Yeah. Yeah, my dad got me, pretty much me and my brother.
And we didn't have a computer yet either.
Yeah. Growing up, guys, my father, who was born in France... Yeah, I have an American mother and a French father. Not many people can say that. Ain't that right, Jay? So, my dad, when he came to America, he loved wrestling. And he would watch WCCW, the Von Erichs and the Freebirds. Or like he would say, the Freebird!
Is it really a free bird?
Well, we know the reason why. They got it from the song, the Freebird song from
Lynyrd
Skynyrd. Because they're from Atlanta, Georgia. And my
dad
would call the Ultimate Warrior the Ultimate Maniac. Remember that, Jay?
Yeah, I remember
It's the Ultimate Maniac! He comes out and runs like a maniac! Well, he wasn't wrong, was he?
No, he was wrong.
Don't listen to him on that. My dad wasn't wrong on that. He did run out like a maniac and shake the ropes. One of my coworkers calls him the ultimate dumbass.
Well, he kind of is. In
Yes, because isn't. What he did. He tried to hold up Vince McMahon for money because he wanted to be paid financially on the same level as Hulk Hogan. But in his right mind, he wasn't on the same level as Hogan.
Well, it was all has to do with his head.
Yeah, remember what he said? You become a legend in your own mind. And that's why he said, you become impossible to work with.
And half the time, I don't even know what he says in his interviews.
Well, he just became, he was intoxicated with the fame. And that's why he wanted to be on top. Once you were on top, and then you want to stay on top. So he did everything he could to stay. Unfortunately, that's not the bright thing in the business. Some people, they try to make champion. Jinder Mahal, they tried to make him a champion. Didn't work. Great Khali.
Yeah, he was champion for a little while.
The only reason he got that belt was because a lot of the SmackDown roster was injured.
They just said, here, be a champion.
Then he was dead, no choice.
He had like a mini good run, at least.
A little bit, but everyone says Jack Swagger was a horrible champion. That's
not really
questionable. What do you think?
What?
Jake Hager is WWE champion?
It was alright.
It was okay. JBL was probably I wasn't a fan of JBL having the belt.
Well, at least he beat Cena.
Like, I'll put it to what Paul Heyman says. The only reason you were WWE champion for years is because Triple H didn't want to work Tuesdays. It's true.
kind of lazy, though. Well, you know, a lot of people are lazy nowadays.
Yeah.
They want to get famous by just doing this.
I mean, who are they going to put it on? Big Show?
No.
Don't get me wrong, I love the Big Show. But he's not a face champion.
Well, at least he was champion for a little bit.
Not everybody could be a Hulk Hogan in the business. I'm sorry to say, Hulk Hogan is the golden child of wrestling. Without Hulk Hogan, we wouldn't have...
And he got his thing from McDonald's.
Yeah, the red and yellow from McDonald's. I knew it was too good to be true. I'll never look at that red and yellow the same thing. I'll just be like, bah, 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 bah. I'm loving it, brother!
That's how he got his gimmick.
I just couldn't believe it. It was from
McDonald's.
Like,
that's odd.
It's very awkward. Yeah. Can you picture Hulk Hogan coming into McDonald's? Okay, brother. I want a Big Mac and a Big Fries. And oh, yeah. I'm going to take these colors and paint them into Hulkamania, brother.
I still think Andre the Giant should have won.
Yeah, but the problem is, who are they going to have to take it off?
No,
they gonna take
he
it
just
off
retired.
Him? That's the thing. How are they going to take it off him? That's the problem. And he goes,
Hey, but look at Yokozuna and Andre. If they were a tag team, that'd be unstoppable.
Yes. Technically, Andre did win the title, but it was only for 5 seconds.
Well, because he didn't want it.
Yeah, that's what puzzled me the most.
I can still help. I want to help you.
Quiet down. Save your strength.
I was a fool. I
was a fool. Soldier go.
There's nothing glamorous about it.
True.
Snake, please save yourself. Go on living and don't give up on people. Don't forget me.
What was that?
Snake, about Meryl.
Colonel, I'm sorry.
Listen to me.
I wasn't able to protect her.
Snake, she's a soldier. She knows that prisoners are a part of war. She joined up of her own free will. I'm sure she was prepared for this.
No. You're wrong. Meryl thought she had to become a soldier. Thought it was the only way. She said she thought it would bring her closer to her dead father.
She said that?
She wasn't ready for real combat. I shouldn't have pushed her so hard. It's all my fault.
It's not like you, Snake.
Master.
Sorry for eavesdropping. But I just couldn't listen anymore.
Master.
Snake, you can never...
See, and why did he do that? He did that on purpose.
But you can't keep attacking yourself for things that happened in the past. That road leads to madness. Believe me.
He's right. Don't kick yourself. It doesn't suit a legend like you. I'm sure Meryl's just fine.
Mei Ling.
Snake, forget about Meryl. Stop Liquid. That's
all
what
right,
Meryl would want too.
Wow.
Right.
Meryl, now we're gonna go for
thing.
A real long climb.
Snake.
What?
Meryl. She's pretty special.
Now listen to this, guys.
Yes.
Jay, pay attention.
She's special. There aren't many women like her around.
Well, I'm just trying to see.
She's the Colonel's niece and a combat buddy.
Is that all? Come on.
This is like a police interrogation.
No,
yeah.
I guess it's in the genes.
The genes? What are you talking about, Colonel?
No, I just remembered about Naomi's grandfather. I think Naomi said he rose as high as assistant secretary in the FBI during Edgar Hoover's time.
Is that right?
Yes, he was Japanese, and he became a special undercover investigator to nab the mafia.
Listen closely.
Sometime in the 50s, I guess.
Where?
New York, I think.
Naomi. I thought you didn't have any family.
Well, I researched it after I became an adult.
My grandfather was already dead by the time I learned about him. I never even had the chance to meet him.
Oh.
Snake, good luck.
Watch your back, Snake.
Something doesn't add up with that story. Did you kind of tell that she was stuttering a bit on her words?
Yes.
We're going to come back to that later, guys, but remember what Naomi said. Alright.
Naomi.
Oh. Again with these damn cameras!
Well, remember, your map is jammed, so...
Yeah, I can't tell where I'm going now because I can't friggin' find anything because the map is jamming it. We're in a blind zone. And I can't use the Nikita either. So I'm basically running blind.
Not for too long, though.
Gonna get the FAMAS.
Huh?
I'm gonna get my FAMAS out.
What's that?
I got body armor B, a bulletproof vest. I'm gonna put that on once I get in there.
How come?
So if I get shot, it reduces the damage. It won't take much. Alright. Shit.
That happens no matter what.
Now you gotta run up all, you gotta run 36 flights of stairs. This is where the analog comes in. Good thing I'm...
We have to do this in one of the Final Fantasies.
Yes, you do.
Not telling you which one. Those games aren't going anywhere anytime soon. We should play Smash Bros.
Yes! One of these days we gotta figure out how to hook up a Nintendo Switch to play Mario Party. Cause that's my main thing I wanna do is Mario.
You know, the Mario series isn't going anywhere either.
That's been going on since 85, bro. Or is it 84?
No, 81.
Oh yeah, 81! Before they were on Nintendo, they were on Atari!
Yeah.
Everyone compares and forgets that. They made their debut
on Atari. It's not 85, it's 81.
Well, yeah, but when the crash of 83 happened, that's when they, what do you call... That's when Nintendo came from the ashes. Now watch this, listen.
Wait a minute, Snake. According to these satellite photos that Mei Ling got, it looks as if there's a walkway on the roof as well.
You can take that to the other side, too.
Be careful, Snake.
Use your throw move on the bad guys that are ch-
Oh, In the next one, the Colonel is going to be very strange.
Use your throw move.
Right, Chris?
Yes.
Like, even in this one, he seems kind of strange now.
Well, yeah. Because he's been lying to you halfway to the game.
I made it to the roof.
You must be exhausted, Snake.
It was no big deal.
Snake, I'm monitoring you closely. Your heart rate is elevated and your breathing is shallow.
What's the matter, Snake? You out of shape from all that dog mushing? Then climb down and proceed north. Otacon, I'm up on the roof.
That was a pretty fast climb.
I wanted to go slowly, but someone there forced me to move faster.
Well, I wonder who's doing that.
Yep. B.
That walkway will take you to Tower B.
I wonder.
All right.
Hey, Chris, I wonder who did that fast.
Yeah.
Was that you? Probably not.
Yeah. I don't know. I want to know who did that.
It was a fourth wall break, sort of.
Yep, breaking the fourth wall there.
Almost.
Plus, another thing why I don't like WWE right now is I'm sick of CM Punk. I used to be a big CM Punk fan, but now after the shit he pulled in AEW, I'm like, screw him. Not to mention he's out of shape. Uh-oh!
I didn't do it!
Jay, we know you're right here. Alright, I wonder what happened here. Well, there goes that satellite in the bridge.
Damn.
Snake!
The Hind D.
I'm afraid I can't let you get past here.
Liquid.
You're not going any farther.
You notice there's two pilots in there, right? It took me 30 years to realize that. Alright, looks like I'm gonna have to use the rope. Now, this is the one part I like about this game. So we're halfway through the game, right, Jay?
I had a rope. I should be.
We hit the halfway mark, guys, with an hour and 13 minutes.
Take on a Hind with your bare hands.
Now he's being an asshole.
Finished.
No shit. That rope. Alright, rope climbing time. I love this part. The only part in any Metal Gear game where you get to use the rope. Besides using a hang glider and a parachute. Remember that?
That was in
the first two. Now,
here's how to rappel. Press the X button.
Yes, I know, Campbell. So, he's used a parachute, a hang glider, Jay, and a rope.
Don't go to the fog.
That's the gas leak, so you gotta watch out, because here's the thing. Now, you could run and repel yourself, but you gotta be very quick with this because, one, if your life bar goes down, you are officially dead and have to do this all over again. So my advice for you
is... Luckily, it's not that far.
It's not far. Here we go. I'm near the net level 6 door.
Congratulations.
It won't open.
Great job! You made it down!
No problem.
Snake, the doorway that leads from the walkway to Tower A is frozen shut. If you use some C4, you should be able to get through.
There we go.
Well, because it was in frost.
But the problem with this is I have to go back out there. You know why? Stinger missile launcher. That's where something like this comes into play.
It's basically you have to come back here. See, they're bad people. Bad, bad, bad.
I'm debating whether I should rebuy some of the games I got on PS4 for PS5.
Nah.
Why? Oh, backwards compatible.
Yeah.
So I'm just going to get games strictly. So I shouldn't get the PS5 version for Resident Evil 5?
No.
Or, 6?
I think it's on there already.
Okay, let me get this guy. Stinger. Yep, got it.
Who's the best boss?
Psychomantis. Without a doubt in this game, it's Psychomantis. Yeah, it doesn't work. Huh? Say it, Jay. Huh?
Huh? I think that's a level 7, I think.
You're at the top of the roof, so... You're pretty high up. I don't know how high up exactly, but pretty damn high.
It doesn't work because you need to do something.
Yeah.
You need to combine it.
Yeah. Hold on, I gotta run down all these steps. See, it's easy going down the stairs, but going up there is a bitch.
Oh no, what happened?
What do you think happened? Liquid.
It's like if you go into a... what is it called? The Empire State Building's stairs.
Yeah, this is pretty much what it's like. Is how many floors does the Empire have?
114, I think.
Yeah, try riding 114. That, or remember the Sears Tower, which is 110? You'll be passed out before you get to number 10.
But I think they have a running a-thon there.
Yeah,
all the
remember
time.
Like in Ghostbusters?
Yeah.
Where they're like, oh, what level are we at? Level 7. You gotta yak. Get a yak.
Huh?
Yeah, I had to take out my fire stick, though, to put the, my USB in.
Don't shoot! It's me, don't shoot! It's me, Snake!
Otacon, how'd you get here?
Well, it wasn't as dramatic as your entrance, believe me. I'm afraid of heights.
Me too.
Were you watching?
Yeah, I was watching.
Or we could do something on my bachelor
truck.
Party. What do you say to Six Flags?
Self-camouflage.
You're not a big roller coaster fan, are you?
The elevator, of course.
Chris, don't.
The first floor of the circular.
You made up your mind already.
All right, yeah.
That's why I took the elevator.
I'm sealed and done.
Yeah, that's right.
Plus, Steph wants it to be low key.
Well,
you're incredible. Like a movie hero or something.
I haven't been to Six Flags since 2015.
No.
I used to get a season pass for Six Flags. I stopped.
The hero always saves the girl.
So I'm always working.
You mean Meryl? Sorry. Forget I said it.
Plus, I'd rather go to Hershey Park.
Snake, there's something I've really got to ask you. It's why I followed you up this far. Have you ever loved someone?
That's what you came to ask?
No, I mean, I was wondering if even soldiers fall in love.
What are you trying to say?
I want to ask you. Do you think love can bloom, even on a battlefield?
Yeah, I do. I think at any time, any place, people can fall in love with each other. But if you love someone, you have to be able to protect them.
I think so too.
I have a favor to ask.
Uh-oh.
Don't worry, it'll be easy.
I told you before, I don't want to hurt anyone.
All right, I gotta pee.
Congratulations.
Entertain him, Jay.
How?
Say what you always say.
Sometimes the stream takes a while for it to catch up. I think on my phone.
La 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 la.
Battery change. Now that light's working.
Congratulations.
That's the only one I can't put a plug in because there's no outlet over there. Or is there?
Congratulations.
Okay, tell me why you did it.
I don't want you to either.
Okay.
The elevator has stopped down there. I want you to get it to move. You see?
That's weird.
It was working before, but now it isn't.
Maybe the panel's broken.
Can you fix it?
It was working before. If it's the mechanism, leave it to me.
I've got to go and swat a noisy fly.
Okay. I'll stay here and hold the fort. Good luck.
You really look like hell. Are you okay?
Don't worry. If I do this, it doesn't matter. I just pretend like I'm not here. And then I'm not scared.
Strange logic. I'm counting on you.
Well, it's time to go take on Liquid in the Hind.
It looks like Liquid really wants to have a showdown with you. I'm looking at Mei Ling's digitally enhanced satellite images right now.
Snake, he's waiting for you. He's just circling around like a buzzard.
I hope everyone's enjoying the live broadcast. Sorry, Snake. Wish I could do something to help.
Snake, I don't like it. Please don't go up to the roof.
I have to. I can't run from this one.
Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to hit that. Why isn't he responding, Jay?
Well, it's obvious reason.
No, Jay, I don't know what that obvious reason is, do you?
We'll get to it later.
Wait a minute, that's not the right way. Can't go up there. Oh, never mind, I'm an idiot.
Why?
Otacon just removed it so I could go up the ladder.
A ladder?
A ladder! Great, I gotta use chaffs.
Well, they don't want you to use that, because that's like kind of cheating a little bit.
No, it ain't.
It is. It's cheating.
It's not cheating.
Don't you have infinite ammo?
No, I don't got the headband. You of all Metal Gear Solid fans should know the only way you get infinite ammo is if you got the headband. Man, how many freaking stairs are there?
I don't know. It says 27.
27? Oh, the floor?
Yeah, it says 27.
Hold on, I'll take a look at it.
27.
It feels more. It feels like it's more than 27. This is going to come in handy body armor.
See? 27.
Oh, yeah, 27. You're right. Why does it feel more?
I don't know.
Anyway, let's go do some damage to that hind.
Are you ready now, my brother?
Why are you calling me brother? Who the hell are
For
you?
For good reason.
I'm you. I'm your shadow.
What?
Ask the father that you killed. I'll send you to hell to meet him.
All right, here we go.
Liquid means to bring this to an end now. He obviously planned this.
Maybe the broken elevator was all part of the trap.
Yep.
Maybe fiddled with the elevator to get me out on the roof.
Yep.
You have to destroy that hind, Snake. You can see the hind on your radar screen. Even if you lose visual contact, you can always check his position by radar.
Your best chance is to hit him while he is circling. When his nose isn't pointed at you, that is your opening. Shove a Stinger missile up his butt.
Up his butt. What about Master?
Yeah, I'm gonna contact him.
Snake, are you okay?
So far, how are you doing?
Sorry, the elevator's not working yet. It's strange, there's no problem with the motor, and the power is on. I need a little more time.
That's interesting. Out of all the times I need him, he's gone.
Are you hurt, Snake? Win, Snake, win!
Another reason why I don't like the Twin Snakes version that much is because they take out the accents in Naomi and Mei Ling. And you see it in the newer versions in Guns of the Patriots. Come on, bitch! Alright, here we go.
You know this is highly unlikely.
Well, you might be right on that. I'm using the analog for this. I got him. You would have to do an incredible amount of damage to the armor on here, but the problem is that body armor, in real life, it would be able to penetrate it.
Yeah, so this would...
Yeah,
because
this that
happen.
Round that he's firing is armor-piercing. It could pierce through a freaking building. Yeah, those rounds that shoot out of a helicopter, that plane right there, can actually pierce through metal in a building. What makes you think they're going to do any better against a freaking... So you're right, my body armor is worthless right now, but it's all I have.
Congratulations.
Oh good, there's more.
Again, congratulations.
Hold on, here he comes.
Yeah, this would never happen though.
Yeah, it breaks the fourth wall, doesn't it?
Happens in a lot of these games.
Hold on, I gotta use this for cover. Shit. He's trying it. I got him.
Nope.
Ah, oh, shit! Come on. Oh, he knows it. Oh, I see him. Yep, there he is.
You're almost halfway, though. This isn't really hard, though.
Just gotta watch out for his detection. Got him before he went under!
Now it's halfway.
I think he's not done. Oh, he's underneath. Yep, there he is. That was a good shot right there.
Well, you gotta do it like
Hold on, try to get a clean shot. Say it, Jake. Say it. You used to say it all the time. Say, eat this. Say it, Jake.
Yeah, eat broccoli. Guess you missed. That time you didn't. Not gonna work like that.
I've done it a couple times like that.
If it was the other way around, yeah. If this was on the other one.
Come on. Get up, Liquid. Get up. Oh, I got you, bitch. Oh, you're dead. You got him. He's fucking chicken shit. He's going under.
See, but the hind would have gone bye-bye by now.
Yeah. He's laying low so he could try to friggin' ambush me. That's what he's doing.
That's why you have the stinger.
No, he can't get me. Come on. Oh shit, here he is. There he is. Oh, he's going under again. Want some more? You want more? In the words of Ray Billings from Tombstone from BattleBots, you want more? Want more? I gotta find some ammo. I need more stinger missiles. Here we go. Alright, I'm gonna stay up in the open now because he's one more hit and he's done. Boom! He's dead. Say it, Jay.
No.
Don't you say no. Wave bye-bye.
No bye-byes.
Do it, Jay. Yeah, you're dead.
Hey, there is a co-pilot there.
Yeah, there's a co-pilot in there. That's the second time we took down a Hind in Metal Gear. Remember? Hell.
Liquid.
Crash.
That takes care of the cremation.
Yep. Here we go, my life went up.
Snake, the elevator's working.
You fixed it?
Why am I not surprised?
That's the weird thing. It just moved by itself. It's headed your way now.
Is that so? Okay.
That explosion before, what was it?
Oh, I had to take out that helicopter.
Helicopter? That's incredible, Snake.
Listen, I just want to make sure again. This is the way to get to where Metal Gear is being stored?
Yeah. The entrance to the underground maintenance base is towards the back of the snowfield ahead.
Okay. Find a safe place to hide out for a while. I'm going underground.
I know. You don't have to tell me.
And stay out of my way. Don't try to be a hero or anything.
Okay. Call me if you need to.
Oh, I will. Wow, look at this is where I was supposed to go. Hey Jay, do you think you fall forever?
Yeah. Forever and ever and ever.
Forever, say it, Jay.
No.
The truth I know. Yeah. Don't you say no.
I didn't do it.
You farted. Oh, that wasn't smart.
What are you doing?
Destroying those, That worked.
Again, congratulations.
I'm gonna come! I'm doing the goulash! You farted!
Who?
You!
No.
Yeah, you!
What are you talking about?
Like Mr. Zip would say.
Who?
You! Remember Mr. Zip, our music teacher?
No.
And Eric's like, me? Yeah, you! Sticking her thumb up his butthole!
Anonymous, Chris.
Yeah, you! Stop sticking your thumb up your butthole!
Say anonymous.
Anonymous. Huh? Jay.
Huh?
Snake, there's something I forgot to tell you before.
What?
There were 5 stealth camouflage prototypes in my lab.
Yeah, so?
If you take out the one I'm wearing, that leaves 4.
Hey, this isn't first grade math class.
I thought I'd get one for you. So I went back to the lab and...
Yeah?
The 4 suits were missing. Also, about the elevator that I checked out, it's really strange. It was like someone was intentionally holding it.
When you were riding on it, did the weight limit warning go off?
That's another thing that bothered me about it. The warning went off, and I know I couldn't be over the limit.
How much do you weigh?
About...
135, but that elevator had a weight limit of 650 pounds.
It would take at least five people to go over that limit.
Look out, Snake!
Oh, shit.
The guys who stole my stealth prototypes are in there with you!
Oh, shit.
Too late, Snake! Now die!
That is kind of creepy.
Yeah, it is, if you think about it. That was easy.
Not really.
Remember, I have it on normal. At least now we can get down to here. Level one.
Did it too early. What are you doing?
I forgot to go through this door. Ah, see? Always check everything. There we go. Before we continue.
A ration.
Huh? What's that?
Colonel, listen to me. I found a parachute near the wreckage of the Hind.
A parachute? You don't think that Liquid survived?
Impossible. As soon as he jumped out of the pilot seat, he'd be sliced up faster than an onion on an infomercial.
So what's that parachute doing there, then?
I have no idea.
A trap?
Either that, or a message. To me.
Meaning I'm not dead, I suppose.
Maybe. But I think it's more like, I'll string you up.
Well, in any case, don't let your guard down.
I won't.
Thank you. What's in here? Never mind, wrong door. Hey. Wonder who that could be. What do you think, Jay?
Your balls. Snake,
are you okay?
Otacon, were there any other stealth prototypes?
No, there were only five.
So, this isn't stealth camouflage then.
What are you talking about?
Someone's aiming at me in the middle of this blizzard.
It's her.
Wolf? Sniper Wolf?
Yes, it's her. It's definitely her.
Otacon, you sound like you're happy.
No, I'm not.
He wants to get laid, that's why.
Snake, please don't kill her.
Are you insane?
Please, she's a good person. You'd know that if you talked to her.
Listen to me, kid. She's a merciless killer.
I can see you perfectly from here.
And so could I.
I told you, I'd never quit the hunt. Now you're mine.
Wolf, no, you can't.
Don't get between a wolf and its prey.
You're pretty good if you can hit me in this storm.
You see, women naturally make better soldiers.
Wolf, don't do this.
Snake, I'm near. Can't you sense me near you?
It's a mistake for a sniper to reveal our location.
Is that right? Well, I'm going to send you a love letter, my dear. Do you know what that is? It's a bullet straight from my gun to your heart.
Please, Wolf! Snake, no!
Quiet! Don't get in our way!
Now I'm gonna pay you back for Meryl.
Big
you
time.
You men are so weak. You could never finish what you start.
You hold that thought, biatch. Oh, shit. Can't go anywhere. Easy way to take out Sniper Wolf here and not get any damage. Just go behind here and you won't get hit. Just do this. This is the most easiest and simplest way to beat Sniper Wolf. You won't have to use a missile launcher, but the thing is, there's not... This wouldn't happen in reality. She'd be blown to bits. One hit, boom, done.
Oh, this is a game.
I know. But yeah, I discovered, like, let me try something. Because the sniper tactic, you're giving her range to actually hit you. You see, the problem is with your Nikita is they don't refill on missiles. So you would have to freaking use them wisely and make sure your hits count. Because if you're not, then you're stuck with the PSG-1 sniper rifle. And not to mention, she moves a lot. And this thing is on a timer because it's fuel timing. Because you see that gauge above on your left part of your screen? Once that runs out, it detonates.
I think you have to say congratulations.
Oh, I got her right in the booty. As you can see, this method is more effective. Wednesday, with your PS5 adventure, you got Tekken 8. Can you believe it's been almost 30 years of Tekken?
It's not going anywhere.
No, it's not. I think Namco started out with just an arcade, and it's grown into a big-ass story. Am I right, Jay?
Mm-hmm.
Just a simple arcade in the arcade arena. Only thing is, the first one was a hard game. You played it, right?
Well, we know who's the last boss.
Heihachi.
Yep. This is weird, though, no Heihachi in the eighth one.
I know. Well, he is dead. For real this time. He thought he was dead in number 5, but he faked it.
Actually, I thought he was dead in number 2, number 3, number 4.
Oh, he survived. Remember, he throws Kazuya in a volcano.
No, but, like, I thought he was dead from 2.
Got her!
Oh, no. Ocelot is going to be mad at you now.
Why?
Because you killed her.
Oh, you mean Otacon?
Yeah, Otacon.
I waited for this moment. I am a sniper. Waiting is my job. Never moving a muscle. Concentrating. I am Longshot.
Meaning she's dead.
Save me. Please. Just finish me quick.
Why, there were two snipers.
I have always dreamed of a peaceful place like this.
Kurd. So that's why you're called Wolf.
I was born on a battlefield. Raised on a battlefield. Gunfire, sirens, and screams. They were my lullabies. Hunted like dogs, day after day. Riven from our ragged shelters. That was my life. Each morning I'd wake up and find a few more of my family or friends dead beside me. I'd stare at the morning sun and pray to make it through the day. The governments of the world turned a blind eye to our misery.
She's talking about number 5.
But then...
Phantom Pain?
Yep. My hero. Saladin.
Yeah, definitely. From the Diamond Dog.
He took me away from all
the Diamond Dogs in this one.
Saladin. You mean Big Boss?
Because that's what he went under at the time in number 5, Saladin.
Hidden. Watching.
That one is going to be a weird one.
It is, because it's got Venom Snake.
Now that's going to be a weird one, though.
I know. I know inside, all about Venom Snake.
But from the outside. As an observer, I watched the brutality, the stupidity of mankind through the scope of my rifle. I joined this group of revolutionaries to take my revenge on the world. But I have shamed myself and my people. I am no longer the wolf I was born to be. In the name of vengeance, I sold my body and my soul. Now I am nothing more than a dog.
Wolves are noble animals.
Yes, they are.
They're not like dogs. In Yupik, the word for wolf is Keglenek, and the Aleuts revere them as honorable cousins. They call mercenaries like us dogs of war.
Yep, see? It's number true. 5, dogs of
We're
war.
All for sale at some price or another. But you're different. Untamed.
So that's premiums to number 5, a Phantom Pain.
You're a wolf.
Which we will get to Metal Gear Solid 5 in the future.
Are you Saladin?
Which, by the way, they're coming out with a Metal Gear Solid 6.
You spared Meryl's life.
They're not going anywhere.
But what are they going to do now?
I have no idea.
Are they going to make Snake do another battle in his previous condition? Or is it going to be another Raiden edition? Or is it going to be a prequel?
I have no idea.
I know, it's been kept in the dark.
I wasn't waiting to
This Metal Gear Solid series has been like a roller coaster, as we would say, am I right? Because 1 minute we got Raiden's Metal Gear Rising,
that was
then
a great
to
game,
Phantom
though.
Pain and Ground Zero. It just, it's twists and turns. They're filling in gaps that we never heard of. But the only problem with number six is Kojima's not going to be a part of it.
I loved you.
What is it?
My gun. Give it to me. She's part of me.
Also, that is very odd.
Yeah.
I mean,
everyone's here now.
Not Ocelot.
Otacon.
Otacon. He's weird.
I know. That's a cry howl for the death of a wolf.
Goodbye.
He had to do it, though.
He had to. She was going to die anyway.
Yeah.
She got shot in the lung. She was not going to live.
Well, if he did it the normal way,
she would have bled out.
Yeah.
She would have bled out internally.
But I couldn't save her. What are you
doing? Arcon, she's not a nice person.
Returning it to its owner. I don't need a handkerchief.
Why?
I don't have any more tears to shed.
Otacon has the worst luck with women. And you're gonna find that out through the series as the series goes on.
Don't trust anyone.
Yeah.
If I can't stop Metal Gear, this whole place will probably be bombed to hell.
Yeah.
We might not meet again.
I'll hang on to my codec. I want to keep helping.
You can leave anytime. Get a head start. A head start on your new life.
Snake! What was she fighting for? What am
you.
I fighting for?
For
what
you.
What are you fighting for?
You.
If we make it through this, I'll tell you.
Okay, I'll be searching too.
Eventually you do come back this way, but the thing is, you see a wolf out here, which I will show you eventually. You see a wolf and you can't kill it, so that makes you question, is that Sniper Wolf reincarnated? I think so. It's like at the end of Red Dead Redemption 2. You see a wolf or a deer, depending on what you get, the good ending or the bad ending. And you see a wolf that runs away, but you can't shoot it. So it's a reincarnated Red Dead Redemption.
And the Strange Man is back in number 2.
Which Strange Man? Oh! Strange Man in Red Dead?
Yeah, in number 2. He's in number 2 also.
I thought he was always there.
He's in the painting this time.
Alright. We're gonna try to get up to Volker Raven and stop it from there.
And then say congratulations.
Congratulations. Because next week will be the conclusion. Just to let you know, we're not going to be doing it Wednesday. We're going to be doing it on Tuesday.
Almost on hump day.
Yes, almost hump day, as Wednesday I would put it.
So where's the wolf?
You don't see it until you come back out. Remember, I get another card to open up something.
Yeah.
Oh, come on. How many more of these frickin' turrets are there?
Well, they don't want you to get any of these, stuff.
I mean, they're nearing the end. They're launching in a few hours. It's like, come on. You're going through all this trouble to make sure it doesn't stop Metal Gear? You've got to take PAL codes and put it so you can launch it any time.
This sounds like, Resident Evil dogs.
Oh yeah, remember from the first one? I swear, everything comes back to a Resident Evil reference. Because there's a lot of Resident Evil references in this game.
Yeah, but two different companies, though.
Yeah, Konami and not Capcom.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Remember there was mines in there?
Unfortunately, I forgot. Hold on, where's the mine detector? There he goes! Ah! Ah! Yeah, this one we have to come back for card 7. Alright. Rest in peace, Wolf.
Well, you gotta get those,
Now, what happens next? Disc 2. But wait!
You don't need to do that.
Actually, I do.
Oh.
What do you think of that? It did it for us!
True.
As you guys know, I have the PS4 application, so... But it did reference the disc, too, because you gotta do something back from the 90s, am I right?
True.
You gotta give something back. Because
at the time, we had to get up and change the disc.
Yeah, change the disc. One was too big to fit on a disc on a pixelated console, on a, what do you call, a pixel console known as the PlayStation 1. Now we don't need two discs.
Actually, there will be in Final Fantasy Rebirth. There's two discs. And that's a rarity nowadays.
Well, hey,
some of them are 4 discs.
Which one? Well, what?
Some of them are 4 discs. Legend of the Dragoon.
Shenmue 1.
That's only 2 discs.
That was 3 discs.
That's 3, yeah.
And Fear Effect. Remember that game?
Yeah.
It's like 3 or 4 discs total.
I think the max was 5, I think.
Possibly, yeah.
I don't remember.
Okay. Watch that. Now, whatever happens, do not... If I let go of this... I am definitely done. I'm in the blast room. So we're up to the underground base, guys. We're in the blast room furnace. And this thing
There was only 2 discs for this one, right?
Yes, it's only 2.
And I think the rest are just 1.
Now, if you really want to... be an asshole and throw somebody over. Get over here. Oh, I couldn't do it right. I can't do it. I'm gonna throw him into the friggin' furnace. I can do it now. Damn it! All right. It's okay, sir. He died in the lava, or in the steel. How does he not see that? Remember, Jay, the booty man! Or the man with no name. It's the booty man booty! He's got a big booty. He goes, hello!
Looking for nothing more than their own death is no good to anyone either. Once she started to look for death, it was all over. That's how you'll end up too, Snake.
Think about that.
That's actually a hint.
Yeah. You gotta think about that for a little bit.
Those pipes are really old. Once in a while they blow out steam, so be careful.
gonna have to use the other one. The chaff.
I got it. Okay, now let's go down. I got what I came here for. So we're gonna go down to... Now this one, just make sure you have a lot of traff grenades, because you're gonna find turrets everywhere in this. Alright, we just passed the 2 hour mark, so we're really gonna extend this, because we're gonna stop this after we beat Vulcan, after we beat the next boss, which isn't too far. I think we all know who the next boss is, right, Jay?
Nope, don't know.
Yeah, he knows.
Well, I know it already because I beat this game already.
But what did you think of that little homage to the second disc?
It's funny.
Yeah, it's neat.
Well, it's like some people don't know how to use a phone.
Trust me. I still have to help my aunt with that.
Well, it's not her fault.
There we go.
This is the second time this happened to him.
I know. It's like they're pulling out all the stops in this one. Like I say, when someone's trying to stop you, you must be close. So if someone's trying to stop you, either way, you're getting close.
Yeah. Your signal is jammed again.
Yeah, that's why I know where the turrets are. That's why Oh, your DualShock got disconnected.
Huh. What?
Hold on. Oh. There you go.
Oh, you know why? Because I didn't, touch it sometimes.
Oh yeah, you gotta touch it or else it's gonna go on rest mode and shut off. That's one of these things about these controllers. They could easily become self-aware.
Yes, I gotta do this sometimes.
Yeah, you gotta touch it. Ah, damn it! Snake! Say it, Jay. Jay, you can't see your face. Cause I love you and I hump you in a gun. I do the ghoulas. Damn it. Oh, right. I got Therm G's.
You forgot?
It's gonna be a long way down, guys.
Congratulations.
Snake. I've got something to tell you about Naomi Hunter.
Here we go.
What about her? Is this conversation secure? Don't worry, the monitor's off. Okay.
Now here it
What's
is.
Up? I was in the FBI too, you know. I didn't know that. What's your point? Dr. Hunter's story about her background, about her grandfather being an assistant secretary to Hoover in the FBI.
Yeah.
And then going undercover to investigate the mafia in New York.
Yeah, what about it?
It was all a big lie.
What did you say?
It was really bothering me. Why would she lie about it?
She lied.
She might be a spy.
Ridiculous.
Come on, even a high school student could see past it.
Yep.
The head of the FBI at that time, Edgar Hoover, he was a well-known racist.
That is true.
Say that her father was Japanese?
Right.
Yeah.
Well, back
yeah, Edgar
then, there
Hoover was
a
well-known
Asian
racist.
Also, in the 1950s, the undercover mafia sting operations hadn't even started yet. They first started in 1960 in Chicago, not New York.
In Chicago, without where
it
started with Al Capone.
The president mysteriously dying, and that ninja. Too many strange things are happening.
Are you saying that Naomi might be behind it?
I don't know. Either that, or she's working with the terrorists.
Could it be?
If I find out anything, I'll call. In the meantime, be careful.
All right, we're at the permafrost. You can tell it's the permafrost right here because this is the coldest thing here. Are you looking up that history of J. Edgar Hoover?
Yeah.
With anything that relates to this?
Yeah.
He was a well-known racist, right?
No, he was an FBI person.
Yeah, and it didn't start in the 1950s. It started in 1960. It's a Chicago sting operation for the mafia. All right, guys. Showdown time. Well, I wonder who this could be, Jay.
Don't know.
Round two, Vulcan Raven.
Welcome, Cossack. This is the end of the road for you. Right, my friends?
Listen, oh, yeah, it says that.
Yep.
How dare you kill my friends? Ravens aren't scavengers like most people think. They're simply returning to the natural world, that which is no longer needed. Sometimes they even attack wounded foxes.
You were the one in the M1 tank? It must have been a tight fit for a big boy like you.
Yep.
But that was no true battle. The Ravens and I were testing to see what kind of man you were.
He's like a little bit of small soldiers.
Oh, Brick Bazooka?
Yeah.
Well, I can see where they got the idea from. Although I will say one thing, you're right about Resident Evil 3, the remake. They kind of piggyback it off of that, remember? The only difference is it's a flamethrower, not a minigun.
Ancestors too were raised on the barren plains of Mongolia. Inuit and Japanese are cousins to each other. We share.
That is true.
Some of this, it's true.
No, it is true because Japanese is close to Alaska where the Inuits lie.
Nevertheless, you will make a
there are some things that are real here that are true.
There's even. There is also a thing called 90 Day of No Sunlight.
Yeah, I know it. Must be a real threat in the muck duck eating contest.
Yes, you are.
That's
right.
A real thing, too.
That
there
is.
Another event that I excel at. It is called the Ear Pool.
That's a real event.
It is
remember on Wild Boys with Steve-O?
While enduring the harsh cold, it tests spiritual
that hurts,
as well
too.
As physical strength.
Yeah, because of the cold.
Pull each other's ears.
Form is different, but the spirit is the same. Rejoice, Snake! Ours will be a glorious battle.
This isn't glorious. It's just plain killing. Violence isn't a sport.
Well, we'll see if there's iron in your words.
Okay. I like to call this the third to the last of the final boss. This is the last member, one member of Foxhound. Because as we know, Decoy Octopus is dead. How? We don't know yet. Hold on, let's go talk to these people.
That room is still under construction, because their main priority was to finish Metal Gear's underground base. But the good thing is, with all those containers, it should be easy to hide, right?
True.
Vulcan Raven is half Native Alaskan American and half Inuit. He was raised as a shaman, and they say he has supernatural powers. During the Cold War, he trained in Russia with the Vimpel, the Soviet Special Forces. In 1993, he was demoted by President Yeltsin following his coup d'etat. So he fled the country and became a mercenary. After that, he joined those rent-a-war bastards at Outer Heaven, Inc. He stayed there until he joined us in Foxhound, thanks to a strong recommendation from Revolver Ocelot.
That cannon he's holding is a 20mm Vulcan gun.
You usually
see them mounted on fighter planes. You can't take him on in a firefight. He'll make mincemeat of you.
He's not just strong, Snake. He's a graduate emeritus from Alaska University, so he's a quick thinker, too.
In any case, you better not try to attack him from the front. Normal weapons are no match for his 20mm Vulcan. Try to attack him from the sides or behind.
Good idea is... from Master.
That place is right in the middle of the permafrost.
For anybody who wants to know what permafrost is... He just answered it for me. It never melts. It's permanently frost.
It's extremely cold there, Snake. If you don't hurry, your sea rations will freeze. One way to prevent your sea rations from freezing is to hold them close to your body by equipping them.
Yeah, because your own body heat could actually...
I didn't tell anything about how to defeat the boss.
I know, when I did that, that's the thing. When you hold it to your body... You're holding it to your body heat so it doesn't stay frozen.
Chris, he didn't say anything about defeating the boss.
I know.
Raven is holding an M61A1 20mm multi-turreted machine gun. They are usually mounted on F-16s.
Yes.
Yes.
This is all real, guys.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah, the dialogue in the military stuff. My uncle would be able to tell you this because he served in Vietnam and he saw this shit. I don't really ask him much about battle. He never really talks about it.
I mean, they don't like talking about it.
He only talks about the good times he had, not the bad.
They don't like talking about it.
Well, he's got PTSD, Jeff.
Most of them do, though.
Oh, yeah, my uncle has PTSD.
Well,
you can't...
some of them.
I'd be shocked if he didn't have PTSD. Alright, now, there's a method of taking out Vulcan Raven. You could do it a lot of ways. You could take him on head-on. You could take him like I'm doing with Claymores to set traps up. Or you could do it the Nikita style. Take him from behind by surprise, because he will take a lot of life out of you if you face him head-on. And always follow, like right here. Here you go. You gotta take him by surprise. Because that gun will kill you, and I'm not even joking. He will take so much out of your health. How many times did it take you to beat Vulcan? Oh, shit.
Two times, I think.
What?
Two.
Yeah, because remember, you're in a place where there's a lot of cover. It's not too hard. You can't die easy, but... you can easily run out of ammo, and if you're running, like Master Miller says, equip the sea rations. Do this the whole time. Equip your sea rations. Otherwise, they will freeze. So equip them to your body. Right now, I'm just trying to collect as much as possible, and I'm going to let him I'm just going to let him destroy everything. Oh, shit. But whatever you do, do not get into that... See, that's his line of fire and his vision. You get into that line, you're done. Oh, can I make it? Yes! Oh yeah, he's coming. I'm gonna set up a trap. You can do C4, but the problem is they're hit or miss. Shit, shit, shit. Yeah, the C4s are hit or miss here. I mean, it's not... coming over here. Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. I'm gonna try to lure him out. Oh wait a minute, I can't. I got the remote detonator. Oh, 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 oh! Oh shit, he saw me!
Well, his line of vision is very easy to see.
It's very easy. Oh, I hate when that happens.
Well, you gotta remember where it is.
Come on out.
Oh shit, I can't. That's the thing. Because if I use the therm G, that's gonna freeze. So you're like stuck in between a rock and a hard place. Oh, he set one of the traps. Up here he comes. Come on. Come on. Oh, shh. Is he coming this way?
Because you have a map.
Oh, I did it on my own. Yep. Now he's getting pissed. Let him shoot everything out.
What does that do?
Because he's going to knock down more of the items. Oh, shit. Okay, I got to put the body armor on. You see what he's doing? Okay, now it's time for the Nikita. Oh shit, he's coming here. Damn it! Well, at least we know what to do now. No more, I won't go through the whole dialogue again. But at least we know how to take him out. Yeah, that was my own fault right there, guys. I should have just, what do you call, aimed better. I have a horrible aiming, but when, like, adrenaline's running, you kind of do the opposite. All right, so I got 2 C rations. Okay, I got 2 C rations, and... it doesn't do it, he's gotta shoot it down. Okay, so here we go. Come on. Gotcha. Yeah, he's getting pissed. Hold on, I see him.
Where? I don't see him.
Come on out, Vulcan. I got a surprise for you.
Are you there?
Oh, shit.
No.
He caught me. Now he's just going to fire wildly. Come on, come on out!
Then you're gonna think you're getting wild.
Oh shit. Oh shit. That was so close! Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit! I love how he could get a hit off me. Oh good, those traps are coming in handy. Hey, idiot, over here! Ah. Snake!
What are you doing? What happened?
Oh. It's my aunt, Patricia.
Why, what'd she say?
Oh, we just need to talk to her about a few things for the wedding.
What are you doing?
Hey Jay, you watch that show Storage Wars?
No.
That show is weird. Never seen people get over sick over storage. Okay, here we go. Round three. I'm gonna try to avoid the mines until absolutely necessary. Got him! I think we should avoid using the claymore mines.
You can't use it. You're not allowed. It's against my religion.
Oh! Oh shit.
I didn't do it! He's mad. Of course he's mad.
I'm just gonna try to beat him as best I can right now.
He would have been badly injured by now.
You would have been freaking dead by now. Mm-hmm.
But it's a game.
Remember. This is video game mode.
Oh, it's video game logic.
Something's creaking. One's falling down.
What was the point of that?
See if I can get it knocked down. I'm tapping as loud as I can and he can't hear me. You heard that? Around the road, he fucked your grandma in the ass. Maybe it's time for the claymores after all.
definitely were.
Come on, get out of here. Damn! I will beat this bastard. It's easier when you don't have freaking... It's easier when you have Game Shark, but when you don't have Game Shark, its thing is like fucking... Oh, hit me with your best shot. And you think that's bad? Wait till we fight Metal Gear. Wait till we get to the final boss. It's going to be even worse. Plus, I'm playing it on normal. So, normal's not the most easiest thing when you want to do a...
But you know, Kelly said congratulations.
Congratulations. Okay. Comes. If he falls for these traps.
Come on now.
Damn it! Take that, bitch. Good, he got one. Got another. Damn it, come on! Okay, I got one of them. Are you shitting me? I hate playing this on normal. I'm gonna give it one last try, and it better be the one. Don't sleep! Where are you going tomorrow for Easter?
Chicken.
Chicken?
Yeah, chicken.
Chicken? Chicken? What's a chicken? I saw it on a rerun, Jay. Say it.
What's a rerun?
Yeah, back then there was no reruns. got him right there. You gotta sneak up. Come on. Chicken pot pie. Yeah. Come on, take the bait. I guess he took that bait. Coming this way. Alright, I almost got him! How did he not see me? Alright, I'm taking his ass out. Make sure, let's see if he hits one of those, Therm G's. I got him right by the balls. He just needs one more frickin' hit. There he is, I got him! Hasta la vista, Vulcan.
Congratulations.
Just as the boss said, it is my existence which is no longer needed in this world. But my body will not remain in this place. My spirit and my flesh will become one with the Ravens. In that way, I will return to Mother Earth who bore me. Snake! I will be watching you! Understand? Snake, take this security card. It will open that door.
Why?
You are a snake which was not created by nature.
Remember about the DARPA chief?
The boss. You are from another world.
We still don't know. What do they mean by killed the DARPA chief? Wasn't the DARPA chief already dead? Or was it something else?
First, I'll give you a hint. The man who you saw die before your eyes.
Here we go.
What is it?
That was not the DARPA chief.
Yep.
It was Decoy Octopus.
So that explains why he's dead in the beginning.
He was a master of disguise.
It was Decoy Octopus.
He copied his subjects down to the blood. So he drained the chief's blood and took it into himself.
It's his face.
But he wasn't able to deceive the Angel of Death.
He died from fox dye.
Uh-huh.
But why go to so much trouble? Why impersonate the chief?
That is the end of my hint. You must solve the rest of the riddle yourself. Snake, in the natural world, there's no such thing as boundless slaughter. There's always an end to it. But you are different.
What are you trying to say?
The path you walk on has no end. Each step you take is paved with the corpses of your enemies. Their souls will haunt you forever. You shall have no peace. Hear me, Snake. My spirit will be watching you.
And life's like that, he's gone. Well, guys, we have run out of time.
Snake, it's me.
But
it's about Naomi. Turn your monitor off.
What about Naomi? Colonel, is Naomi there?
No, she's away. She's taking a short nap. So what is this about Naomi?
Okay, maybe we'd better let the Colonel hear this too.
Yeah, go on, Master.
Well, basically, Dr. Naomi Hunter is not Dr. Naomi Hunter at all.
What?
I thought her story of her background sounded kind of fishy, so I checked it out.
And?
There is an actual Dr. Naomi Hunter, or I should say, there was one. But she's not the woman we know. The real Naomi Hunter disappeared somewhere in the Middle East. Our Naomi must have somehow obtained her identification papers.
So then, who is she really?
She must be some kind of spy.
Ooh. A spy?
Yes. Maybe she's been sent to sabotage this operation.
Are you saying she's with the terrorists? I don't want to believe it either, but she is working for Foxhound. So you think she had a part in the uprising?
Or she could be working with some different group altogether.
Different group? It couldn't be.
Place her under arrest.
What?
She's betrayed us. She needs to be arrested and interrogated.
Why is he so committed to that?
If she's one of their spies, then we're in big trouble. What do you mean? Oh, nothing.
Have you let her in on some kind of vital secret or something? Does this have anything to do with the mysterious deaths of the DARPA chief and the Arms Tech president?
I have no idea.
Bullshit.
Anyway, we cannot allow her to participate any further in this mission.
Wait a minute. Without her, we can't complete this mission. I knew it. You're hiding something. Give me some time. I'll try to get it out of her.
Hurry then. We've got to figure out who she is and what she's doing here.
I understand. Snake, give me some time. I don't have any time left for you.
Boom. Alright, guys, with that being said, I'm going to save it from here. And we're going to pick off on Tuesday next week.
Naomi wasn't acting strangely or anything?
No, I just can't believe that Naomi's an enemy spy. I refuse to accept that.
I don't want to believe it either, but...
Don't say it, Snake.
All right. All right, guys, we're going to wrap it up for tonight. Stay tuned for next week for the finale of Metal Gear Solid. We hope you like this video. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, Jay. Show them that thumb. Hit that thumb.
See this thumb?
Yep, like see this that thumb? Wiggle that thumb. And don't forget to like us on Facebook and follow us on Instagram. And don't forget to subscribe to also Magic Moments with Mike Spade. Until then, I'm going to 916.
Win, Jay.
Say game on. See you on Tuesday.